what is very beautiful in the morning, I was actually here on Thursday morning, and I had a wonderful visitor, John Denton Mays, and he's going to be doing a column on these. But anyway, we were sitting basically where Gerard is now, and at 10 o'clock the light came in through the window, and the whole thing turned into a, it was amazing, because it's like a rainbow, it just sits there for 15 minutes, and then at 1 o'clock it happened again on this side. But it didn't happen the next day when I came to take the picture. I've got one picture in the catalog from that day. So, but if you can, you can sort of see the letters. You can, if you look against the light, can you see the letters all the way around the edge? So anyway, when I do the lecture, I'll be explaining, somewhere in the bag, somewhere, I've got a little, you know, brochure for those of you, and I can send you all the story, because we're basically looking at the divine universe in the center of the earth in 1268. The dome jar in the center, it's a portion of this. It's got the whole thing. So this one is text, mostly text, and also the way that the whole Great Pavement was planned out into these very specific proportions. So that area is within. You see the corner and the corner and there. So it's within that sort of space. The outside rondelles are all the way in, so the millions of the world. It gets more exclusive the closer you get to the middle, because the center is the center of the universe. So this is missing, if you can imagine, if we wanted to add on a whole bunch extra. But I didn't want to do it any smaller, because I figured that the letters wouldn't really show. And in another lifetime, when someone throws another few thousand dollars at me, I'll finish it, and people will actually be able to read it if they're good at Latin. How do we like the lighting, by the way? Lower, higher, vote. We need vote. This is better? Okay, this is better, fine. So I'm just going to adjust that, and are we good to go? And you have to sort of make yourselves known to each other, please. And we're off to the races. And first of all, thank you very much for coming. This has been, like, exhausting. I actually saw that for the first time in my life 2 days ago. Because I'm working in a studio space, which is about not even a quarter of that, and we're having to roll it up. I mean, I didn't see it. So the thing was, you think, and of course the rods are 3 10-foot pipe, and they've got joiners on them, and my wonderful people at Home Hardware helped me figure out how to do that. So Lionel, the other wonderful janitor, helped me put these up. He goes up in the roof, and these the Maria is here. You know that joiner before you got her. So what happens is those rods kind of come down from the ceiling to about there, and there's the two of us putting these things together. We really hope this is all going to hang together, because if it doesn't, it's going to make one hell of a noise. And then we got these funny kind of weird things, and the whole thing kind of goes up a bit by bit. You have to sort of pull it up, and it's a slight bow. I mean, in the perfect world, it would be nice, because that's what's making it hang a little bit, because of the bow. And I'm actually going to draw the corners because I'm flat. But the church in the daytime, they prefer to have them tied away for security, so I'm going to do that right now. And I'll just get on for that, and we will get going. And thank you. Thank you very much.
Mr. Peter Wozniak here. What do you think, Pete? What do you think of this
work?
Well,
I think the work is lovely. I don't have a whole lot of understanding about what it is, and that's why I'm here. I'm here to also support Jacqueline, and I would really like to see these works with the sun shining from behind them, which I don't think is going to happen today, but that's okay. And but they look like they have taken a lot of work.